Hello everybody, and this is another episode of Beastworm Gaming, and today I want to talk to you about hive slots. I am at 40 right now. I have good equipment. As you can see, I have the bear bee. The bear bee is great because the bee ability token rate is very high. You're faster. Pollen comes out more. It's just a great bee. But this is who I am. I'm a pollinator. I'm a farmer. The pack holds more. I just don't have to go through this like all the time. I've got the guards, the shoes, the pack. I'm not an attacker. That's going to come later with the demon mask. But to start to become an attacker, what you need is more bees, right? The minimum amount of bees that an attacker should have is 45. The minimum amount of bees that a farmer should have is 45. 45 is a good number because you can evenly do a level 12 on 45 bees and get things such as the majority of them gifted. You can have all the event bees in there. You can start to design your hive look, such as if you want it to be white focused, a certain field focused. You can have lines in there. You can have spices in there. You can have fuzzies in there, because there is enough room at 45 bees. Also, the cost is relatively easy too. When you start to do the last five, that's when things start to get really costly. But at 45, things are pretty manageable. I'm up here because I'm at a low cost enough where the 41st bee is still less than 2 billion, right? I also have a gold gifted egg from Riley Bee. I believe Bucko Bee also gives a gold gift egg at the completion of the 50th mission. Okay, so that's the purpose of this video. We're going to go in here. We're going to buy the hive slot. That's not bad. Buy it. And the next one is a billion more. So that's actually not bad. But then you'll start to see, like after this, things get quite high and they get quite high fast. And that's kind of what separates individuals in terms of their commitment to the game. It separates them to how they design their hives. Because trust me, what really makes this game progressively effective for some people is leveling up their bees, not just having a lot of bees, but leveling up their bees, as well as having enough hive slots, because you have to make a choice between bees, leveling up your bees, and how you design your hive slots. Okay, so this is what we're going to hope for. We don't want a gifted baby bee. It's not what we want. We don't want a gifted ninja bee. Doesn't really add anything. A gifted shy bee, that would be good. Gifted shy bees are good, especially for red fields. A gifted demon bee, a gifted lion bee, those are both good bees to have. So already there's three bees that I would not mind having. I believe, what other legendary bees are there? There's the diamond bee. That would be a new gifted bee, which is good for the future attainment of the supreme amulet. Also, at some point, when you get into that 20-30 base pollen, and you have to go back to the hive, you start to see, it's not really lagging from the pollen to the honey, but it starts to slow down. So having the diamond bee and its gift is good. It's good to have. A second music bee, that's good to have too. So you start to look at things and say, you know, a gifted everything bee except for the baby bee is not that bad. Another carpenter bee, not the most exciting thing, but it's not the worst thing either. Now, I also think because it's a gold egg, there's even the possibility of, unfortunately, getting these, an epic, yes. And there are some epics that I do not want. But you look at the epics and you're like, okay. Well, I don't have the bumblebee, and I have two frogs, so that would be good. Bucklebee, it's always good. Commander bee, increases crit chance, that's good for different reasons. Demo bee, that's okay. Exhausted bee, okay. Fire bee is good because I got spicy. Frosty bee, not that excited, but it does help with bombs, and that's good. Honeybee, that's good. Actually, that'd be very good because of the coin scatter. That increases the honey money, and I don't have one already. Ragebee, I always love ragebees. Rileybee, that's not bad. Not bad. Shockedbee, I don't have a shockedbee. That increases white pollen. So really, this golden egg that's gifted is going to help me out. Is going to help me out. Alright. So let's put it in. Let's get it. Let's get it. Gift a gold egg. Really the only one that I don't want is a baby bee. So no baby bee. No baby bee. We go, hatch, gift a gold egg, gifted shock bee, and I think I had one, but let's see, gifted shock bee, no, this is a new bee, this is a new bee, this is a new bee, good, 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 good. And this is the one with the plus 25% white pollen. Good. Very, 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 very good. Very good. I love this. And it gives a haste token. And it gives a token link. Very good. And I think I have the neon berries. So let's do that. Let's give it a neon berry. And that brings it up to a level 4. Very cool. And let's give it a bitter berry, which will level it up to, and I'm actually trying to see if I can get anything. Okay. Okay, I guess I didn't do anything but level it up. So, I guess I learned something. But that's good. Let's quickly look at white pollen. White pollen, 452. That's not bad. Actually, that's very good. Very good. Okay, so new bee, new gifted bee. So, I like that. Alright. So, good day. Good day. Good day.